Dairy farms, landfills, and oil wells have two things in common. They stink, and they produce methane.
Most methane is flared, meaning it's combusted and emitted back into the atmosphere as carbon dioxide. This is a major contributor of greenhouse gas, but it's also a waste of a valuable chemical feedstock.
Researchers at Pacific Northwest National Laboratory have developed a technology that uses bacteria to turn methane into useful goo.
Our end product is microbial biomass. Literally, it's slime. But this slime has value. Biomass itself is a chemical feedstock for transportation fuels, but it's also a way to sequester and store this carbon so that it can be used in different ways.
Other uses include specialty bioproducts like plastic, and even a source of food for livestock. The researchers tested their technology on gas collected from manure on a dairy farm. Hans explains how the team brought together two bacteria to turn gas into goo.
So the principle behind the co-culture technology is metabolic coupling. On one hand, you have a cyanobacteria. It's a photosynthetic organism that uses light to make oxygen. On the other hand, you have a methane oxidizer. It consumes methane and uses oxygen to do it. So photosynthesis produces the oxygen required by the methane oxidizing bacteria. It converts the methane into its biomass, thereby making carbon dioxide that the cyanobacteria convert into its biomass. So we just close the loop. But this is a way for us to find two organisms, willfully coordinate their metabolism for an application such as capturing wasted methane and converting it into transportation fuels, specialty bioproducts, or agricultural feedstocks. It doesn't smell good and it doesn't look tasty, but it is valuable.